Welcome to Elite Chronoscope, level 8. I thought this would be a really nice challenge. I already did sort of a dry run. I went to the first fight, and it was quite a challenge, and I think I'm going to have to drink pots for this for sure. So, but I think I can do it. I have never soloed this at level on Elite. I've done it Epic Elite, I think, at level 28. But never Heroic Elite at level solo. So we'll see how it goes. I made some equipment changes just for the raid. I decided to get, and this is a tip, thanks to, I can't remember who it was on the forums, but you can buy hide armor from the vendor in the harbor, and then you can disjunct it to craft on it, and hide armor gives much better PRR than the light or the cloth armor. And just want to show you for comparison, bring up my character sheet here. You can see I have 69 PRR with the frozen tunic, only 31, and that's 23.6% damage mitigation. And then I'm just going to use the leather armor. This is plus 3 skirmish leather of invulnerability that my wolf is wearing, and here you're going to see that the PRR goes up to 51, MRR up to 25. Notice the armor class is 46. Now this hide armor, this doesn't have like a skirmish and a plain forged version or whatever. So this is like base hide armor. So you're gonna actually notice the armor class go down by one, but the PRR goes up up to 69. So now we're up to 40, almost 41% damage mitigation and 40 MRR. So I'm going to be wearing this for the raid. I thought that would be helpful, and to compensate for the fact I don't have glaciation and ice lore from the tunic, I picked up a caster stick with glaciation and ice lore on it. So I won't really have much to swing at mobs, but my melee damage is not where it's at on this build anyways. And if I need to, I can just switch back to my regular scimitar. It's up to plus 4 acid flame touched of bleeding right now. And the shield is up to plus 3 heavy dark wood shield of invulnerability. Goggles of resistance 4, that's the same. Braces of wind, that's the same. Greater false life on the ring, that's the same as last video. Feather falling boots of melee alacrity 10%, that's the same. Ogre power plus 5 gloves, the same. Ring of heavy fortification. Health plus 5 belt. I forgot my my augment, so I'm down 60 spell points. That's okay. We got pots. Cloak of Flames is the same. Vibrant Purple Ion Stone for the big spell points at low level. Evocation Focus 2 necklace and Wisdom 5 on the helm. I haven't talked about skill points, but I'm really just following the build that I have posted on the forums, so I'm maxing out Concentration and Heal and Intimidate, and then I'm also putting some points in Use Magic Device. I always like to put 1 point in Tumble on my tunes, and then when I get higher level and I have more skill points to play with, because I'll have more benefit from my higher level intelligence tomes, then I'll be putting the remaining points in Balance. So the wolf, you saw his armor already, plus 3 invulnerability, and then this collar is new for level 8. This is a nice collar I found a while ago. It's got plus 2 acid burst of lacerating on it that has slicing and bleeding, and then I put festival frost on it last year as well. For spells this level, picked up flame strike. Not the greatest spell, but if I need to do like some AoE where mobs are, where cold isn't doing it, then I can use flame strike. And then also picked up Sleet Storm as my extra level 3 spell, so that will give me some crowd control in here as well. Here goes nothing. these casters first. A betrayal. The entity known as Professor Trim has sought to destroy us. Oh no. Now we got to go up here and talk to Vahir Fenord. His mother apparently didn't like him too much. Showed this on, if you didn't know, you can ask, can you give me any aid? And then he gives Eagle Splendor, aid, and bless as well. So that's kind of cool. I showed this in a little trivia video I did a while ago, but if you never noticed, Vela and Sidonie are back here behind the tower. And that's Vela, the red dragon from the Vault of Night raid. She's here in elven form. Pretty cool. Nice little Easter egg. Tying the stories together. And as I mentioned in my crafting video, in case you haven't seen it though, you can get flame-touched iron weapons here, and you can pull these right out of Chronoscope, and you can disjunct them to use them as crafting blanks. Pretty nice. Which is exactly what I did with my flame touch scimitar that I have here. Going to be primarily healing myself with potions of cure serious wounds here, but I do have vigor as well, and I did normally I'd have maximize off for that because I feel like it's more efficient like to just use that for like maintenance healing as needed, but I may need some more oomph to my healing spells for this raid, so I put maximize on. Gonna skip the optionals. It's just gonna take a lot of extra time. Probably should have got a wand of shield to help mitigate his magic missiles, but oh well. So these guys are pretty serious here, but the ice storm and creeping cold is going to take care of them. It'll take a little time, but it's alright. Could have just ran by these guys, but I don't need them. Give me a hard time when I'm trying to move between zones. Abishai somewhere. There he is. Mailbox is a chest. Yoink. Okay, let's use the shrine in here before we do the first big fight. I'll just redo the dog's buffs because I can. In case it runs unexpectedly long. Only 8 minutes left on the buffs, it could very easily take longer than that. Let's do the Yugo pots too. That'll be helpful. The Twisted Talisman. This comes out of Last Stand and Red Fen. It's a very nice little mana clicky. Gives you 3 clickies of plus 50 spell points. Each one is at a cost of 25 health, but you can obviously easily just heal yourself. But it only regenerates one of those charges per rest, though. So you can't continuously use all 3 charges. Still a very nice item. Pretty easy farm out of Last Stand as well. Quicken yet, but I will next level. That'll be my 9th level feat. Spring's Resurgence will do a pretty good job of keeping the wolf healed, but I have to make sure I stay on top of that. Just using Wands of Cure Critical to keep the wolf healed. I'll take out these casters first. Here comes the big boy. Got him down to 10,000. He starts out at 15,000 hit points, so getting there. Comes again. Look at Snarl go, he's a champ. I didn't see what he was at. I don't know if you can examine his health while he's up there. No. So he's at 7,000, about half right now. We're definitely drinking pots. When I did my dry run, I got him down to like 5% before I was out of mana. It's just a little less efficient this time. Really just using SLAs too. Except for the ice storm, obviously not an SLA, but in terms of call lightning and creeping cold and the produce flame. Some of that aggro off Snarl by intimidating the mobs. There's a blood plate. Hopefully get him down this time. there goes Blood Plate. You know, if I had played my cards better, probably could have done this fight without drinking a pot, but oh well. I'd had my my spell point augment in, and then maybe use the last two charges on my Twisted Talisman. Or just been a little more patient. Infested Armor. That's a nice, really nice armor. That's level 4. Obviously, I can't wear it as steel, but level 4, spell resistance 19. A little bit of forward on there. Disease guard, kind of neat. Yeah, pretty good. Pretty good heavy armor for level 4. Rebuffing the dog before I rest. I didn't have to use any healing other than potions and wands in that fight, though. Let's refresh the Yugo pots. Only had 5 minutes left. So now, if the dogs, as long as the dog's obedient, which is rare these days since they made the changes a couple updates ago, then what I can do is I can just run over to the next place. Probably should invis, but I'm not going to. Hopefully I can make it there without spiking the DA. The here again. We'll get some more aid from him. Oh. Shoot, I'm doing things in the wrong order. Not cool. Gotta get the key from the bank. Alright. Then come over here. Fellas, we'll be fighting you soon enough. Little Easter egg here, if you never noticed, Johann Lennon, like John Lennon. funny, you know, you do this with a big group and usually somebody else doing this, so oftentimes don't even think about it. Look at this clown following us in here. I'm not even gonna waste resources on him. Oh, I haven't buffed myself yet. Now I'll call the wolf to us. Let's give him a fresh spring's resurgence. Off of the wolf. Make sure the wolf's attacking Razor Arm. There is a Razor Arm. Guess we have to go find him. There he is. Now, if I wanted to just drink a bunch of pots, I could just spam call lightnings on them. But I'm trying to do this without using a lot of resources. Can't even hit him with this caster stick. More call lightning should do it. There we go. Bring the rest of the trash down to the bottom. Well, no pots there. This next fight should be pretty tough. just gonna let the ice storm chew this guy, these guys down. It's gonna take a minute, but it'll be the most efficient way to do it. Snarl's laying down on the job. Ice storm will hurt the ones that are even immune to cold. I can't remember which one of these guys are immune to what, but ice storm does bludgeoning damage as well. So Squall's immune to electricity. I'm gonna put the fire absorption on for this fight. And the electrical absorption as well. Voltron's up there forming. Can use some mana clickies. No time like the present to use all three clickies on the talisman. Have to be very careful about using the cold dots on him when he's in the white dragon mode. I'm pretty sure that will heal him. Or maybe he'll just be immune, I can't remember. almost 50. Just the regular unmaximized, unempowered produced flame right now is hitting them for 139, 129. Not too bad. Nice, no pots, just the one pot in the first fight. It's a lot better than I thought it was going to turn out. Got some collectibles you can hit while we're waiting for the portal to come up. Time to go back to Shavrath and be put to the question. And that is Elite at Level Solo Chronoscope. Woot! Thanks for watching. If you have any questions about my videos, you can respond on YouTube. If you have any questions about my build, you can respond in the DDO forums in the Druid section. And if you happen to be on Sarlona, you are welcome to send me a tell.